fuels have got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Fossil fuels have got to go.
I teach at the College of the Marshall Islands, the first college in the Micronesia to divest. So even though we're a small college, even though we don't even have as much funds as some of these bigger institutions, we took the step to divest. And the reason was because it depends on our survival. We will do everything we can to save our islands. So I'll be sharing a poem about the beauty of our islands and what we want the world to know, which is that we shouldn't have to leave and that we shouldn't have to move from our islands because of the flooding.
So the Marshallese people, we are living on tiny coral atolls, and they're just about, some of them are smaller than the size of this conference. In fact, I was just talking to someone who said that there's 40,000 people here at this conference. There's 60,000 people in the Marshall Islands. So that's actually almost the population of the Marshall Islands. So we have been, we're, point being, we are very, very vulnerable. There are parts of the island where it's so small and so thin.
I'm personally concerned with climate change because we're seeing the effects of climate change right now. We're living with the effects. I just visited an island just this past weekend that used to be lush, that used to have trees and coconut trees, and that used to have fruit and crabs and everything. And now, after just 10 years, it's completely dead. All it's just sand and a pile of rocks, and that's all. And that was within 10 years of time, you know. So what I saw when I saw this island is that this is what the rest of our islands will look like, that our islands will not be livable because of the rising sea levels if we don't do something about climate change right now. And so it's the survival of our home, my homeland. This is why I'm involved in climate change work.
And it's a poem that I wrote about the importance of the number 2 degrees versus the 1.5 degrees of global warming. The other night, my one-year-old was a fever pressed against my chest. Together, we wrestled with a thermometer that read 99.8 degrees. The doctor says technically 100.4 is a fever, but I can see her flushed face, how she drapes across my lap, listless. Libinum is usually a wobbly walking toddler, all chunks and duck-footed, shaky knees, stomping squeaky yellow light-up shoes across the edge of the reef. And I think what a difference a few degrees can make.
I think there's many mediums to fight climate change, and I think exploring all options is really necessary because as far as negotiations, as far as the science, those are hard for people to understand, and it strips the humanity of the issue. And what poetry does is it brings humanity, it touches people, and it moves people so that it becomes not just about numbers and distant figures, but it's actually people who are being affected, and it's the stories that we remember. And so that's what poetry has the power to do.
My father tells me, Irik, the Marshallese word for when the tide is at an equilibrium, is the best time for fishing. Maybe that's what I'm doing. I'm riding the tide towards an equilibrium, willing the world to find its balance so that people remember that beyond the discussions, beyond the statistics, there are people all the way out here. There are faces. There is a baby walking wobbly across the edge of a reef, not yet underwater. Thank you.